Saltwater Kingdom is the inheritance bestowed upon sons and daughters of the ancient Saltwater Kingdom Everlasting, Saltwater Kingdom. These are elaborate children, created of saltwater combined within flesh. Naturally possessing supernatural powers, in order to rid the world of wickedness, and to balance evil. Saltwater Kingdom. Section 1. I've seen places while my eyes were closed that captures the mental complexity of my imagination. In this case, the word of my mouth, "Let there be light," once again holds truth. Non-fictional realities and fictional characters are my reality. Saltwater Kingdom is of earth and ocean, in and near the sea. Glorious cities within and upon seawater. Teenage girls tending to children. Light, dark, colorful children. I've dreamed of them, and with my own eyes I've seen them. There is no entrance into their world without divinity. Jesus is their God, and neither he nor I abandon ship. Beware and compare not their kingdom to their ancestors' nightmares. For they are inheritors of dreams, fantasies, sea warriors, and victories. Section 2. Many years ago, there were a people. These peoples were made by God himself, and God made them in flesh with salt and flesh. And God blessed these people, and he said unto them, "My people, go to the land that I gave you," and the land that the Lord God giveth them was pleasurable. And was prosperous. It was a beautiful land, and he built a kingdom for them upon that land, and they became kings and kings' men, and they had animals, and they had salt, grains of salt, and this salt was given to them by God to be prosperous, so that they may deal in the dwellings of salt and distribute the salt amongst the land to make money and shekels and gold and silver, so that people would deal with them continually, and they were blessed. The salt lived in them and dwelleth outside of them, and they were a prosperous people, a prosperous kingdom, and the one king of them who were the king of all the king's men sat on his throne and dwelleth. But God has something to say. Section 3. And God said unto them, "I ask that you do one thing for me, as I giveth you all these things forever and have blessed them, but you must do this for me." And he told the people, he told the king, he told the king's men, "I will send some more of my people to you from time to time, and I would need you to take care of them, bring them in, house them, clothe them, allow themselves to be cleaned, and be jolly with them from time to time. They may stay with you upon weeks for as long as 3 months, then they may be on their way either before the 3 months or there after the 3 months." And that was the deal, and the people and the king's men and the king himself said unto God, "Yes, we will." And then a year went by, and suddenly a visitor, a fellow, came into the kingdom, and he told the king and the king's men and all the people. He said unto them, "I am of God's people. God has sent me to your kingdom to be looked after." And they agreed, and they took him in, they cleaned him up, and they fed him, and they talked with him for as much as 3 months, and then the young fellow went on his way. And soon after another visitor appeared, she came as the second visitor, and she told the people and she told the king and the king's men the same thing the first visitor said. She said, "I am of God. God has sent me here, and he says unto me that I should come here and be looked after." And they agreed, and they took her in, and they clothed her and cleaned her and fed her, and soon after she was on her way, maybe a month later. Section 4. And this continued to happen throughout the kingdom at least 10 times a year, and sometimes there were 2 or 3 or a family, and the king and the king's men and all the people took care of all the visitors that God sent, as they agreed they would. However, after 7 years the king and the king's men and all the people of the kingdom were tired and disgusted and angry, full of anger for taking care of these visitors, these foreigners, that God keeps sending. And so, the king and the king's men and the people expressed their anger amongst each other. They had meetings upon meetings daily, and they were angry, and they said unto themselves, "We do not want to do this anymore." So, when the next visitor came, he was by himself, all alone. And he said as all the other visitors said, and they brought him in, but this time they slew him, they killed him. And they cut his body parts and buried them on the land in which their kingdom stood. And the king said, "This is what we shall continue to do. Why should God send these foreigners among us? Does he love them more? For he must, because we take care of them, they do not take care of us. We shall kill everyone he sends." So, in 1 year the king and the king's men and the people there at the kingdom killed a total of 10 peoples of God. And then an angel appeared from God, and he said, I am an angel sent from thy God, and he has sent me to tell you that he is angry with you. And that ye shall all repent for 3 months straight, that he may give you a light punishment, but if thou shall not repent for 3 months, thou shall have a harsh punishment, and he shall bring an enemy that shall wreak havoc against you and reign over you, and half of your kingdom will be unto him. So, the angel left, and the people and the king's men and all of the kingdom with the king came together and said, we shall not repent, we shall prepare for war against our upcoming enemy. Section 5. So, they prepared, and there were meetings upon meetings daily, and without repenting and without thinking of God they continued to suit up for war, and they agreed as part of a plan to create a protector. One that would protect them from all of God's sendings. And this protector would have nothing to do with their loins, for they were made of salt. So, this new creation, this new one, will not be made of salt. For they figured, that God will send one, twice or three times as strong as they are and as mighty as they are, as they are mighty in salt. And so, they planned against salt, and they called their creation pepper, black pepper. And they sent their creation through their distribution lines, and it was distributed through all stores and restaurants and all of the places of the land. And all of the people that came and bought salt also bought pepper. And all of the people, when they ate their meals, they ate with salt and pepper. It became a combination, and it was beautiful, and it was prosperous. And the pepper was there to protect the salt. And it made a combination unlike any. And it became world-renowned and worldwide. So, the king and the king's men, and the whole kingdom, and all of the people of it, were prepared to war with God. And whatever or whoever he sends. Whomever he sends, they were prepared to war against. And they waited, and 3 months came, but the angel never appeared. Nor did any enemy, nor did any word of God. And they waited and continued to wait. But nothing or no one ever came. One day a customer came to the kingdom to pick up his daily grain of salt and pepper. And he ordered 5 pounds of pepper, and he normally orders 5 pounds of salt, but he asked of the seller, to only give him 2 pounds of salt, but yet he needed the 5 pounds of pepper. But then the seller asked him, why do you only need 2 pounds of salt? And the buyer said, well, my customers realize now that salt is pretty much in everything, and that their need of salt is not as important as they thought at first, but they need the pepper, because pepper is not in everything as salt is. And then the buyer said to the seller, your kingdom has encouraged me to go into the pepper business. For I am creating a new pepper, called red pepper. And then the seller, which is of the kingdom, knew, and he went and took all these things that were said to the king. And to the heart of the kingdom. And they knew that God used their own works against them, as he is the Almighty God. But even worse for them, was that they felt a heartache because they did not listen to God. So, they felt abandoned and disconnected. And the only thing that could soothe this feeling, that will be with them forever, because they did not repent for 3 months as God said. The only thing that could soothe this sorrow was black pepper. Because their bodies were filled with salt, and salt caused ilmatic problems, it caused sicknesses in their bodies, so they could not eat as much. For they were made with so much salt, and they loved to eat salt, but they could not eat it anymore, as they once did. And they were forced to balance salt shakers with black pepper. And though black pepper was given half of the kingdom, it reigns over the whole kingdom, as it reigns over sodium and all salt-related healthcare issues. It nurses all salt and sodium oxide related ailments, just as they created it to do. Black pepper reigns over all peppers, now and forevermore, without ending. Saltwater KingdomE.